Hi everyone, Eternal here. I felt the need to do some blogging and have some cake. My sister called me today, and her oldest son is getting married tomorrow at 3 o'clock to a girl that he met on MySpace. She's a total sweetheart. They absolutely adore each other, and he proposed to her 4 months ago, and he said he just had to wait for her to pull her head out of her butt to finally realize that this was the thing to do. He originally wanted to do it just like a little, it's a place called the Hitching Post. It's over in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. And as soon as his mom and her parents found out about it, well, his mom's my sister, but as soon as she and her parents found out about it, they're like, oh, we gotta be there, we gotta have a big thing, we gotta have a shindig. So, needless to say, there's gonna be a bunch of people there, which they didn't originally want. Afterwards, they're gonna go to a barbecue at her parents' place, which, if anybody knows the Northwest area, they're getting married in Coeur d'Alene. They live here in Spokane, and their reception that's going to be thrown by her parents is going to be up in Tum Tum. So they've got some driving ahead of them tomorrow. In the summer they want to do like a luau type thing, which I think would be kind of cool. You know, the whole pig roast and tiki torches and the whole spiel. He's already figured he's going to be inviting a minimum of 50 people to this, so they're going to have a whole pig. And for those of you who are shallow and judgmental, yeah, I'll be there. So that's the whole pig. Okay, that's about it for his excitement. To his sister, she's been married to her husband for 3 or 4 years now, 5 years, I think. They're getting divorced. She had met a guy that she kind of started to develop feelings for, but she knew that it was a bad idea. And she'd written this guy a note and everything, but she had never gave it to him. She just kept it in her purse and, you know, kept putting it off, throwing it away. Well, her husband found out about this note somehow from somebody and decided he was going to go through her purse. Now, guys out there, no matter how suspicious you are of your woman, don't go through her purse. That, you know, he's lucky he didn't get his head chopped off right, you know, either one chopped off right then and there. And this is really freaking good. She caught him, walked in on him going through her purse, and told him, you know, that's it, we're done, you know, fuck it, get out of my house, we're getting divorced. So there's that. Now on a little closer to home, my son, my 7-year-old bubby, went with his mother and her rent payer, well, the father of her daughter, let's put it that way. They went to a barbecue to a friend of theirs house, and she was having, I can't remember what she was having, but it was like 80% fruit juice. And he, the rent payer, the father of the daughter, felt that he can drink a case of beer a day after he gets off work, but she can't have a couple of very mild drinks that are more a cool-off thing than anything. So he decided he was going to reach around from behind her and just snatch the drink out of her hand. Well, he split her lip. He was tossed out of the house, out of where they were having the barbecue, And he went home, called me crying. And needless to say, my ex-wife called the cops and had him arrested. They've got a temporary restraining order. Well, I'm sure it's a permanent one now. I haven't heard from her today. I don't have my phone here with me. He can't come anywhere within 200 feet of her, my ex-wife, or his daughter. Now, if he's already gotten this order, if it's already been served on him, I can guarantee you he went into a rage. Because he really loves that little girl. And it's a major screw-up on his part, what he did. But c'est la vie. She, the ex-wife, is getting ready to get into another apartment, which he will not know the address for. He will have no way to get a hold of her. If he tries to contact her through me, through my wife, or any other mutual friends, he'll go right back to jail for violation of the protection order. This guy apparently served in law enforcement in England. He was like Royal British Navy, security. He held all kinds of positions in which, you know, he knows the law and knows how to act in accordance with the law. He is a security guard here. I believe he was also a police officer at one time here in the States. So he knows that if he screws up and violates that order, he's going to jail. God damn, this cake is good. So, yeah, that's it for that. My wife loved her new job. She's been there for a couple of weeks now. And almost like 90% of the people there know her, who she is on a first name basis. Cake all gone. A few other people will walk up and hug her. Excuse me about it. Must consume washed down cake. That was good. I know I can do better than that. Anyway, that's about it from here. Thank you for spending time listening and watching me enjoy my cake. Until my next video blog, comment on my others, please. I'm beginning to think nobody loves me except my good friend Gina down in Texas. And Tom, I know you're out there somewhere. You were one of the first ones to ever comment on any of my series videos. Just let me know you're alive. Just say hi or something. So, until then, I don't have the dead soldier, so here's my rhino. Bye-bye.